your hands together for Jesus. Appreciate him, appreciate him, appreciate him, appreciate him, appreciate him, appreciate him with a clap of him, with a clap of him. Bless the name of the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord. Shout hallelujah. Amen. You may be seated. Now let's go into the message for the Holy Communion. Let's bow down our heads in prayer. Lord Jesus, thank you for the grace you have given us once again to gather at your feet for the Holy Communion. Jehovah God, we appreciate you. We bless your holy name. We give glory to you. Who is like unto you, Lord? None can be compared with you in heaven above and on earth below. You are God of gods and the Lord of lords and the King of kings. Lord, we say, blessed be your holy name. Receive our thanks, receive our worship, receive all adoration in Jesus' name. Amen. Divine Father, speak to us. We are praying, prepare us for heaven. Even as we partake in your supper, eating on the dining with you, God, make us part of your kingdom in heaven. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. As somebody say again, Amen. The theme for this conference is actually on the dry bone that shall live again. Tell somebody near you, let your dry bone live. Tell the other person, let your dry bone live. Our dry bone shall live in Jesus' name. Every dry bone in our life shall live in Jesus' name. For we serve a living God. So everything about us should be alive. That is also the reason why we are saying scripturally and biblically, you cannot use attachment, because attachment is a dead material. There's no life in it. You cannot use artificial nail, because it is a dead material. There's no life in it. All these things being added to the body, they are dead materials. But we are alive, and our God lives forever. We are waiting for him, for the rapture. Even if death comes earlier, we are trusting God that we shall make it. Our life shall end in heaven and not in hell. So that's why the unclean things we don't touch is a commandment. It's something we understand well. All these things I mentioned, they are unclean. You are using them as part of the dry bone. If you cut your hair attachment, it will never grow, because there is no life in it. It's not connected to the bloodstream, for life is in the blood. But the natural hair, if you cut it, it will grow. The natural nail, if you cut it, it will grow. It's normal, because the life of God is there. He gave life. It's connected. That's why you see that everything that man has tried to replicate, everything you can, they can put your artificial hand, artificial leg, but there is no artificial blood. Blood is blood. Somebody say, blood is blood. Just as God is God. Our dry bones shall live. All the petty sins in our lives. Some are strong ones. As we say, we are preparing to meet our Lord, our God in heaven. Then we should be prepared. With hoping. That preparation has to do with doing away with all these things, in whichever way and whichever form, in whichever color, in whichever dimension, in whichever depth, We have to do away with them. In fact, Bible says we should be living stones, just as Christ is a living stone. Not a dead stone, but a living one. Though a stone, but alive. Stone in the sense of strength. Stone in the sense of strength. Like a rock. Like the rock of Gibraltar. But having life connected to the life of Christ. 1 Peter chapter 2. I read from verse 1. It says, wherefore, laying aside all malice and all guile and hypocrisies and envies and all evil speakings. These are the kind of things that contaminate life, that deaden you spiritually. Though you are still living, you can carry your hand. In fact, you can run. You can jump. But spiritually dead. God saying, no. You can have these things in your life and claim to be alive. No. In fact, it's not that kind of person that should be at the Lord's table. What has the clean got to do with the unclean? Is Christ a minister of sin? No. Christ is holy. God is holy. Heaven is holy. The angels are holy. God has nothing to do with sinner in terms of relationship. Real relationship with God begins at the time you are born again. Giving your life to Christ. Forsaking your sin. Repenting of them, turning a new life, then a new chapter is open for you. It is at that time you have a record in heaven. But outside this, all labor in the vineyard of God is labor in vain, because there is nowhere to record your activities. Yes, you are sweating and laboring, but nowhere to record it. Because a student in the university, after gaining admission, must register. Registration is the first thing. If you don't register and you are going to the classes, in fact, you come out with high GP, first class by what just cost, you cannot get any certificate, because where do they record it? So that's why we are saying, let your dry bones live. Let your life be a living stone. Make your life a living stone like Christ. Taking away all these things, malice, envy, corruption, evil speaking, pride, filthy attires, filthy relationships. Do away with them. Hypocrisies, pretending to be a Christian, but you are not. How can a witch be taking the Holy Communion? But they do. A witch is taking Holy Communion. For what reason? It does not belong to your kingdom. Holy Communion does not belong to your kingdom. Why are you taking it? If not deception, if not hypocrisy. God is clean and pure. And that's how he wants you also to be. He says, as newborn babies, desire the sincere milk of the word, that ye may grow thereby. If so, be ye have tested that the Lord is gracious. To whom coming as unto a living stone, disallowed indeed of man, but chosen of God, and very precious. It's not ordinary. Jesus is precious. You too, you are supposed to be precious. You are not an ordinary person. Some people have come to this conference. Right in this conference, they have become born again. You are born again even for 1 hour, for 5 minutes. In the eyes of God, you are higher than the president of the United States of America who is not born again. Is it like that? You are a higher citizen because your name is registered in heaven. You have to be a living stone, alive in Christ, pure, clean. All these filthiness, do away with them. Those are the kind of people Jesus is inviting to his table. Say, come and dine with me. It's a privilege. Because we don't see Christ, that's why this book that was used for book review, that's Remember Jesus. I love that book because I see it as an inspirational book. When you read that book regularly, you will not forget Jesus in a hurry. Because Jesus is a wonderful companion. And remembering him keeps you away from sin. Because you will wonder, why should I hurt him? What evil has Jesus done to me that I should hurt him? You'll be afraid to sin. Because he has shown so much love to you, abundant love, great love. Why will I hurt him? Why will I hurt somebody that loves me so much, that sacrificed so much for me, that's so patient with me, so tolerant? Even sometimes when I'm going into error, he's still patient with me. My son, why are you doing that? He's not a bully. Jesus is not a bully. Very friendly, very loving, very kind, and very sympathetic. He's a comforter. Why should I hurt him? He's higher than us in all ways. But he said, no, you are my friend. Come to me. Let us dine together. And that's what we want to do now. So if you are not a friend of Jesus, what do you want to do on his dining table? Jesus said, no, don't come. Until you are ready for me, don't what? Don't come. It's not for people like you. Don't come. This is what God wants us to be. Living stone. Children of God. A holy nation. He calls us a peculiar people. He said, once we were in darkness, once we were not a people. No, we were not. We are not a people. We are not a people of God. But by his marvelous grace, he took us out of our thick darkness into his wonderful light. He gave us a new name, a new identity. This is wonderful. Put your hands together for Jesus. Jesus is good. Jesus is wonderful. Jesus is great. A very good companion. I love Jesus. Somebody say, I love Jesus. I didn't hear you. I will not hurt him. So, my brothers, my sisters, we have been here since Tuesday up to now. Something must have happened to us. Something must have changed about us. Let it not end here. Let's continue with it. I say, let's continue with it. Jesus is coming soon. Let's continue with it. By and by, gradually and gradually, steadily and steadily, we'll enter heaven. I will not miss it. I'm talking about myself. I will not miss it. And God will help all of us in Jesus' name. Let's see what the scripture says about the Holy Communion. In 1 Corinthians 11, well, let's go to Luke 22. Luke 22 from verse 14. Praise the Lord. It says, Luke 22 from verse 14, and when the hour was come, he sat down and the 12 apostles with him. When the hour has come, when the hour has come to take this communion, even now, Jesus is here with us. Is he here? He's here with us because we are dining with him. He's here with us. He came before the conference. He has not left because the conference is not yet over. He must see us through. And he must see us home. Amen. We will not die on the way. Amen. So the hour has come. Along with the apostles. And he said unto them, with desire, I have desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I say unto you, I will not anymore eat thereof until it be fulfilled in the kingdom of God. And he took the cup and gave thanks and said, take this and divide it among yourselves. For I say unto you, I will not drink of the fruit of the wine until the kingdom of God shall come. And he took the bread and gave thanks and break it, and gave unto them, saying, this is my body, which is given to you. This do in remembrance of me. Likewise also, the cup, after supper, saying, the cup is the, what? New Testament. In what? In my blood. Which is what? What a wonderful Jesus. I give you the bread as my flesh. It's symbolic. I give you the wine as my blood. I shed it for you. Remember how I suffered. Some people were wise enough. They did that film, Passion of Christ. When it came out that time, many people, they were crying. But maybe those sadness and crying will have been over. They might have gone back into sin again. But truly, Jesus suffered. And he shed his blood. Very precious, but he shed it. And he had to shed it. Not for his own sake, but for you and for me. I am praying. The shed blood of Christ on Calvary shall not be in vain for us in Jesus' name. Because if we come to this knowledge of truth in a place like this, and we still don't make it, it shall be too terrible. It shall be too terrible. The greatest regret in hell will be, why did I miss this great opportunity? Because I shouldn't be here. I say you will not be there. You will not miss heaven. You will not enter hell. Every sacrifice that is necessary to be made will make it. And God will help us in Jesus' name. To conclude, let's go to 1 Corinthians 11. Verse 17. It says, now in this that I declare unto you, I praise you not that ye come together, not for the for the better, but for the worse. For first of all, when ye come together in the church, I hear that there be divisions among you, and I partly believe it. For there must be also heresies among you, that they which are approved may be made manifest among you. When ye come together, therefore, into one place, this is not to eat the Lord's Supper. For in eating everyone taketh before other his own supper. And one is hungry, another is drunken. What? Have ye not houses to eat and to drink in? Or despise ye the church of God, and shame them that have not? What shall I say unto you? Shall I praise you in this? I praise you not. For I have received of the Lord that which also I deliver unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he brake it and said. It's a tradition handed over by Jesus Christ. It is one part of his, there are two in particular that he mentioned. Baptism by water and Holy Communion. Ordinances that should be observed by the church. Baptism by water, Holy Communion. Ordinances that should be observed by the church. You cannot miss it. To violate it becomes a sin. And on the account of that alone, no heaven. So this tradition was handed over by Jesus. It was inaugurated by Jesus and handed over to the apostles. And they practiced it all through the New Testament church, the early church. And as they passed on, they handed it over. And that's what we are continuing to today. That's why we are taking this supper. Because Jesus instructed it. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. Remember how I suffered for you. Each time you take this communion, remember how I suffered for you. How I was flogged for sins that are not mine. I suffered for you. Dangerous weapon used on me. I suffered for you. Remember me. Don't forget me. I won't forget Jesus. I say I won't forget Jesus. I say I will not forget Jesus. He said, don't forget me. And then he says, after the same manner also, he took the cup when he had supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do as oft as you drink it for remembrance of me. Take it regularly. Don't be miserly with it. Take it as often as you can. That is why at every conference we take it. And so at this conference, we are taking it again. If you know you are born again, your hands are pure, your hands are clean, your heart is clean, you know you have a relationship with Christ. Even if you are born again in this conference, you can take it. Don't run away. Take it. It's your right. Or privilege, whichever way you want to say it, to see it. Take it. Take it. You'll be obeying Christ. And obedience is righteousness. Take it. And as you take it, it will work fine for you. It will not work negatively in your body. But if you know you are not sure, leave it. There's still a question mark in your life. Please leave it. So so that you will not be condemned. So that Jesus will not flog you. God will help us so that even as we follow all these ordinances and do all this, it will not be in vain. It shall not be in vain. As we gather here to eat at the Lord's table, we shall gather there to also sup with him. In the name of Jesus. You will not miss it. I will not miss it. I will not miss it. You will not miss it. We shall all make it. In the name of Jesus. Give a clap offering to Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.